In this video, we're going to look at a way of combining the Apollo hardware direct monitoring features with Logic's software monitoring in order to get the best of both worlds. Now, I've discussed my basic signal flow in a previous video, but I'll just do a quick overview. This is my main setup where I have a send on each track set up going to a bus called Headphone 1 and Headphone 2. And they arrive at these buses here, and they're outputting to QMix 1 left, right, and QMix 2 left, right. So that's how I'm feeding my headphone mixes for talent that's performing. I dial up levels that I want. They're arriving at QMix 1 and 2. And then in the console app, I have QMix 1 going to Headphone 1 output, and QMix 2 going to Headphone 2 output. And that's my basic monitoring setup. Now, here's a typical scenario. Let's say I'm recording, and I've got a send set up. In this case, I'm sending to aux 1, and on aux 1, I have a reverb. It's muted right now so that we don't hear it on my voice in this video. But a typical scenario is I'm tracking maybe a lead vocal, and I want to monitor with some reverb. So I have this set up here, and I have this set to monitor only, so that as I'm recording, I'm hearing the reverb. And then once the track is recorded back in Logic, we'll have it here and it'll be dry, and then I can mix using whatever I want. Now that's great, but what happens when you want to punch in? Now I've been recording, monitoring with this reverb over here, and if I want to punch in, the pre-roll that I'm going to be listening to is dry. And then as soon as I punch in, I'll hear that reverb again. So that's not really a great workflow. Now you might figure, okay, I'll set up another send here, and I'll send to reverb, and because my track is record enabled, I can send here, and I should be hearing reverb. But you're not gonna be, because the conventional workflow is that we have software monitoring disabled, meaning even though this is record enabled and there's signal passing through here, it's not getting sent through here to monitor this reverb. And it doesn't matter if this is post fader or pre fader, you're gonna get the same effect either way, nothing. So here's a way of combining the best of both worlds of software monitoring and hardware monitoring. I'm going to call up the audio preferences again, and under general, it's really important that we leave this on in order for this technique to work, independent monitoring level for record-enabled channel strips. What that means is that Logic will remember the state of this fader when it's in playback mode separately from when it's in record mode. So what we can do then is enable software monitoring, and I'm going to mute this for the moment. And then we record enable the track and pull the fader all the way down. Now by doing this, we basically have hardware monitoring with software monitoring enabled. What I mean by that is, because this is pulled down, no signal is being fed through here and being sent out to the Apollo hardware. So this is basically like having software monitoring off for this track. And because of that preference for the independent levels, when I turn it off, remembers the level for playback mode, and it could be anywhere, it could be higher or lower, and then it'll remember those two states separately. So when we're record-enabled, we're in console, and we're working the same way as always, we're monitoring our signal through here, and nothing else is getting through. So what's the good of this, you might wonder? Well, if we're using a pre-fader send, and it's important that this is pre-fader, I can now send signal, and we're going to hear it in the headphones. So one workflow that I prescribe for this type of scenario when you need to punch in is this. We'll go to this reverb that we've been monitoring with, and I'm going to go down here and copy the settings. And that's a great feature that allows us to copy the settings between different platforms. I'm going to go back here, and on this bus send, I'm going to call up that Universal Audio reverb, Dreamverb, over here. And now I can paste in that setting. And now what I can do is enable this, and now monitor as I'm recording with this Dreamverb. I'll mute it for the moment. So it's important that this is a pre-fader send, and on this aux strip with the reverb, make sure you're sending to your headphone 1 and headphone 2 so that you can monitor this reverb in your headphones while you're tracking, as well as while you're listening back. So with this workflow, what I'm suggesting is that in console, you don't actually use Dreamverb. You don't use it in there. Instead, you enable software monitoring, make sure there's independent levels, and pull this down all the way when record enabled, set up a pre-fader send, and instantiate your universal audio reverb on the aux track with a send set up to your headphones. And that'll get you the best of both worlds. As you're recording, with this pulled down, you'll be hearing the no latency direct monitoring through console, and you'll also be hearing the software reverb through Logic's monitoring, and the slight latency on a reverb or this kind of effect is really inconsequential. So just to summarize the setup here, in Logic's audio preferences, make sure to enable the option for independent monitoring level for record-enabled channel strips, and also enable software monitoring. And then in Logic on the channel strip, record-enable the track and pull the fader all the way to the bottom. And in my custom template, I've already record-enabled each track and pulled them all the way to the bottom so that it's ready to go. As soon as I hit record, it already snaps down to that position. Then set up a pre-fader send that's going to an aux track. And on that aux track, call up your UAD reverb of choice to monitor with. And also make sure to set up sends there that are going to route the signal to the Q1 and Q2. So this way, you can do your tracking with your universal audio reverb all within Logic. And then when you need to punch in, all you need to do is bring your region down to another track. And I've set all my tracks up with this same setup with the reverb send and the headphone sends. And then place that playback track on there. And then you can punch in on this track. And you'll be hearing the reverb here based on the send. And then you'll be able to track and hear your reverb while you're tracking based on this pre-fader send here. So that's a nice way of enjoying the best of both worlds of direct monitoring and software monitoring.